So for 4 days, I had to sit at home naked because I had a botched laser hair removal from this botched business from a Connie. Coffee is needed for this wonderful story. Well, this video is going to be quite graphic, detailed, and I might get a little angry, so let's just jump on into it. This video is all about my botched laser hair removal. It's a really fun story. So if you guys are watching this video because you are not sure if you want to get laser hair removal or not, you might want to watch this first. I am not legally allowed to say the name of this company, and I will get into the reason why later. But basically, let's just call it botched business, because that's what I got. So I'm gonna need to give you guys some sort of background information on why I decided to get laser hair removal. So I was a competitive gymnast for about 7 years, and while I was in gymnastics, I started puberty, meaning that I started to grow hair in places that were not there before. Let me just tell you, if you guys are a gymnast, and if you had coaches who basically banned shorts over your Leos, you know how uncomfortable it feels. Basically, that meant as soon as I started growing hair, I took that away. And I shaved, literally shaved, almost every other day. Not because I had to, but because I was so scared. And my legs are the same way. Like, my hair on my armpits and my legs grow back very quickly, genetics. Traditionally, like, with my legs, I shave like every 3 to 4 days, or if I don't care, I just don't shave at all. Like, all of quarantine, I have not shaved. Until today, I shaved today. When you shave really often, it tends to give you razor bumps, irritation, itching, all kinds of fun stuff. So after years and years and years of doing this, it became pretty much like a habit and I had to. You have all heard, if you shave, it'll grow back thicker and longer, whatever. Well, that's definitely the case down there, and it also became a habit and just that's the way I lived. I shaved like every other day to every 3 days. And again, I'm talking about bikini area. So about 2 years ago, 2018, I decided I was so sick and tired of shaving. It would itch so bad after the first day. I'd put coconut oil on it, it would tend to burn it. It was just a lot. I remember just being really upset about it. And this is even after I quit gymnastics. I quit gymnastics when I was 16 years old. So from 16 to like 19, I still shaved like every other day to every 3 days, and it was just creating a lot of irritation. I was just so freaking sick of it. So I did some research, and you know, I've heard a lot about laser hair removal. I watched a lot of videos on YouTube, and everyone had really good experiences. So I was listening on the radio one day, and a very well-known business, which is Botched Business, okay? Botched Business has locations in I think every state. So listening on the radio one day, I heard of this Botched Business, and they had a little commercial segment. It said they're having this huge discount and blah, blah, blah. You know, it was a limited time discount, and they didn't have any prices in their commercial. So I did a little research online from this Botched Business that I am not allowed to say, which again, I wish I could. So I decided to call. I asked what their prices were, and they specifically told me, and I wish I had this recorded. They told me, we do not give prices over the phone because everyone's hair is different. So we assess the hair and we give you a quote. And I said, oh, that makes sense. They said, if you have reddish hair or different types of hair or whatever, you may not be a good candidate for laser hair removal because the laser doesn't affect those types of hairs. And I said, that makes total sense. Well, I would like to make an appointment for a consultation, which is free. I went ahead with it, and I went, forcing my friend to come with me because I did not want to go alone. But because I didn't get any prices over the phone, I thought this was my only option. I have to do it because this is so freaking frustrating, and I'm sick of feeling like this. I went to the appointment, filled out 10 pages of paperwork before I went in. I sat down, me and my friend, at this lady's office, which she was a total con artist. I'm gonna call her Connie for con artist. Connie whips out a pamphlet with prices, prices on them, guys. She said, these are our base prices for laser hair removal. And I said, I thought you don't give base prices, it's depending on the person. And she completely ignored what I said and jumped into like talking about other stuff about laser hair removal. I brought it up again. She ignored me again. So I was like, okay, maybe like I'm mistaken or something, whatever. So basically it was gonna be $3,000 for 10 sessions. I'm 19. I had a minimum wage job, but she was a damn good salesman. As she was ignoring all of my questions, she had these base prices, whatever, and I was dead straight. I signed my life away. And I told her, you know, I'm not sure, I wanna consult my mom first. At this point, my mom had no idea where I was. She had no idea I was doing this or that I was about to spend this much money. The lady said, well, unfortunately, if you leave this office, the discount no longer applies. What kind of conny person would tell that to a 19-year-old? Excuse me, I need to go talk to my mom and consult her about this and ask her if I should, like, I'm over 18, but, you know, I trust my mom's opinion, and usually she's been around, she knows these types of things. She would have told me, get the F out of there and do not sign any papers because that's sketchy AF, okay? This lady told me if I leave the office to call my mom, the discount drops. So I said, okay, let's just do it anyways. I signed that document. I signed the consent. I signed that contract, Melanie Lee, and I dated it. It was $300 down. I was like, oh, I got this. I pay once a month every time I go, and I get it lasered once a month, right? Well, on the phone, when I called to make this appointment, again, no price, couldn't tell me a price. They said, come with grown out hair so we can assess it. My friend warning me not to do it, and I ignored her, and I still signed those documents. And, you know, I was like, hold up, I forgot after I signed. I was like, wait, I thought you guys were gonna assess my hair to give me a quote price because everyone's hair is different and the prices are different, right? Like, you told me that, Karen. So as she filed all the paperwork that I just signed, I started remembering that when I was on the phone the first time making this consultation appointment, they told me to come with the hair grown out. That way they can assess it for price. They never assessed me. They never looked at it. So she said, okay, well, do you want to do your first session today? And I said, I might as well. I'm already here. So she walks me to the back room where they have the table set up and everything. And she said, okay, so-and-so will be in here and they'll shave you and they'll do the procedure. So I sat down thinking that this lady was gonna shave me, and she puts on the goggles, gets everything together, whips out the big laser, and she's like, okay, are you ready? And I had my friend sitting next to me, by the way, the whole time. She was laughing. She still to this day can't not believe that I did that, and I did not listen to her. That thing freaking hurts. It hurts, it hurts, it hurts. I made my friend in the middle of the session go get me Chick-fil-A ice so I can chew on ice while she's doing this to me because it hurt. I did not have fun. Towards the end of it, it was a lot better, I would say, but the experience pretty much hurt, and I said ow every single time. Then I started asking this lady questions. She was a really, really nice, sweet lady. She is not a Connie whatsoever. She was just doing her job. She's a really sweet lady. And I started to ask, does it hurt more when you do it on hair that's grown out? And she goes, oh yeah, it hurts way worse. And I said, wait, can you stop for a second? This Connie lady told me that you were gonna shave me first. And she goes, oh no, like, we don't always do that. We expect you to do that before you come in. And I said, that freaking lady told me to come with hair grown out to assess it, didn't assess it, gave me the base prices, and then she says you're gonna shave me. You don't shave me, and I find out it hurts worse when you're not shaved. Why? Went throughout this whole thing and it freaking hurt. Okay guys, like, I'm not over exaggerating. It hurt when you have grown out hair. Now I think if you don't have hair and they use it, like, I have very high pain tolerance, it probably wouldn't hurt whatsoever. But the fact that it was on grown out stubbly hair was very painful. So I finished up with the session and I left, and I was like, okay, whatever, that sucked. Only a few more times and I will be fine, and I'll finally have no more issues down there, right? Rungo, I had so many issues after that appointment. I come home that day in pain, put some coconut oil on it, I think is what I did, and basically it hurt to touch, it hurt when things touch it. I had to basically sleep naked with no sheets on me because it burnt and curled up the hair that it would pool on sheets. This hair was so freaking weird. I can grab a piece and pull it out of my skin. Grab a piece and pull it out of my skin, and pull it out and pull it out and pull it out. And eventually I just had to pull out all of my hair down there because it would stick to things and it would pull my skin with it and it would hurt so bad. I couldn't wear underwear, couldn't wear yoga pants, couldn't basically do anything. 4 days I had to sit at home naked because I had a botched clay hair removal from this botched business from a connie, aka a con artist. This botched business is like nationwide. After that, I had to do a 7-hour road trip to Arizona to go pick up my IKEA furniture. Walking around IKEA was miserable. I couldn't wear yoga pants, I couldn't wear underwear. It was just a freaking nightmare. After all of this happened, and I was like, this is not right. Like, I feel violated, I feel lied to. I don't want to go back there. I was in pain. I was actually in pain. It hurt so bad from this sizzled up burnt hair touching everything. The skin was super sensitive. I just feel like they did not go about it professionally whatsoever. They lied to me. So me and my mom got on the phone. So I called this Connie back up with my mom on the phone and we fought this girl. It was really, really disgusting because this lady was rude and said, well, your daughter's 19, she should have known what she was signing and this and that, and I would never let my daughter do anything like that without my permission. And I was like, miss, I asked to get my mom's opinion in your office and you said no. You said if I walked outside that I would lose a discount. So it was just so bad. I had to get my bank involved. I had to record some of the stuff over the phone and talk to them about it. It was just this huge ordeal. After that, I lost the deposit. It was $300. That's fine. I was no longer in the contract for $3,000, which great, because that would have been a nightmare. And if it worked, you know, if I went through all 10 sessions, if it worked well for me, if these people were nice and treated me respectfully and didn't lie to me, I would have absolutely gone through and paid the $3,000 because that was worth it to me. I'm not joking, you guys. I really wanted to do this because of how much discomfort I was in and razor bumps and all of these issues. I just wanted it to be gone and this seemed like it was the only option. You guys, I have tried everything. I've tried shaving with coconut oil, doing all of these crazy things, waxing, whatever, nothing would work. Obviously, my mom was real mad at me because I didn't tell her until afterward. But luckily, she was nice enough to help me out of the situation. And, you know, I feel like I tried my hardest not to take advantage of the situation whatsoever. But I really did not deserve that. And I really feel like they were taking advantage of our younger girl just looking to get help. After that whole shenanigans, basically, in order to get out of the contract, I had to sign another contract. I guess it would be called an NDA, I think. But basically, I signed that I would not talk about this business. I would not share my experience. I would not say the business's name, blah, blah, blah. But I read that contract again, and I can talk about it all I want. I just can't say the name of this botched business. Although, I would absolutely, because I would advise every single one of you not to go to this place. After all the pain, after all my hair fell out, then came the shedding process of all of my hair, and I went through really weird seasons with it. Basically, it has never been the same. So after all the hair fell out, it took quite a while for it to grow back. This was 2 years ago, so it's slightly hard for me to recall, but I remember I didn't really try to shave it as much just because I didn't want to irritate it, but it would grow back extremely dark and full and thicker than it ever was before. And then I would shave and it wouldn't come back for weeks, like weeks and weeks. And then it'd be super light and I'd like have no hair. It was the most bizarre thing ever. For about a year, it was like every time it would grow back, it was different. And sometimes it was better and sometimes it was worse. But basically since then, I have not had any issues with razor bumps really. No issues basically down there whatsoever. So that one session did me well, I think. I don't know. It was a terrible experience because I should not have had hair. Should have been fully shaved for all of that. Though I still do have hair, 1000%. I just don't have any issues with it. So will I ever try laser hair removal again? Maybe if I really go in and trust a business. I don't think I'll ever trust a business again that won't let me call my mom if I have a question. I highly suggest to watch many more videos about this topic, but the main thing, I think you should protect yourself when you go in for an appointment. Don't go alone. Bring someone who who you trust along with you that is going to listen to your concerns as well as the person who is trying to sell you something, because they are selling you something. That is just my opinion on that. Please protect yourself. Do your research with these companies. Make sure they give you a quote price before you go in. So many red flags for me that I should have paid attention to, and I cannot tell you how absolutely disappointed and dumb I feel from that whole experience. I was just so desperate, and that's what desperate people do. They do some weird stuff. Please do not forget to leave this video a thumbs up and subscribe to my YouTube channel. I will see you guys in the next video. Thank you guys so much for watching if you stuck around this long. Bye.